Hi, I'm Thomas Davies and I'm doing my presentation on the South Korea Free Trade Agreement. Korea has a population of 51.4 million people and is rapidly still growing. Korea has one of the biggest economies in the world and is currently the 13th largest. Korea has the 27th most wealthiest country in the world with personal GDP $28,000. Since the Korean War in the 1960s, the demographics has changed remarkably in Korea, from 75% rural population to a current 82% urban. This has meant a rapid increase in reliance on imported food products, especially. Korea is one of our largest export destinations, and trade and import has reached $4 billion. How does this free trade agreement affect New Zealand? Tariffs will be eliminated on 98% of products over time. This will happen in stages over the next 15 years. This will create better access to high quality Korean goods for New Zealand business and consumers. Increased cooperation to create new opportunities for New Zealand will occur in the agriculture, education, trade facilitation, science and technology, film and television industries. A clear and detailed process to settle disputes related to free trade agreements will occur as well. Potential for New Zealand's primary industry is significant. In the last two decades, Koreans have consumed 43.8 kg of milk and that has now increased to 72.4 kg at the moment. New Zealand has experienced rapid growth in trade since the agreement was signed, and that has increased by 16%. Beef is by far the most popular red meat among Korean consumers, and has increased from 11 kg, and that is expected to increase at 1 to 2% per annum for the next few years. Big winners for New Zealand are the kiwi fruit industry, with 45% of tariffs eliminated over 6 years, 89% will be eliminated of butter over 10 years, 36% will be eliminated of cheese over 12 years, 10% will be eliminated of wood within 10, and 20% will be eliminated of salmon over the next 4 years. The biggest losers for New Zealand is our milk industry, with milk powder especially. The Koreans will keep 176% tariff. Frozen and unprocessed deer velvet will keep its 15% tariff. Fresh abalone and frozen squid will keep the 22% tariff, and two types of wood export will keep their tariffs as well. Future trade potential for New Zealand is notably the European Free Trade Agreement, which is currently in discussion, the Trans-Pacific Partnership without the USA, and a potential United Kingdom Free Trade Agreement. In summary, I believe free trade agreements such as the one with Korea is crucial for our primary industry success in the future. Asia is one of the biggest populations in the world, and economic and personal wealth is still growing. The Asian continent is home to one of the world's biggest and most biggest economies, and New Zealand should be proactive to seek and capture future trade. Korea and China are prime examples of this. Thank you.